your notes are scattered between screenshots, loose paper, or apps that you probably barely even use, I'm gonna show you how to unlock the full potential of Apple Notes so you can take, organize, and actually use your notes every day. Whether you're in school, managing work projects, or just trying to stay top of daily life, today's video will help you build a system so that you can feel organized, inspired, and focused all inside of Apple Notes. Now, quick thanks to Moff for sponsoring today's video, but we're gonna talk more about that in just a bit. Let's get into it. Now, the best iPad for note-taking, it honestly depends on what your workflow is. For me, it's the 13-inch iPad Air. The extra screen space makes a huge difference for handwriting, multitasking, and when pulling in reference material without the iPad feeling very cramped. Now, I also use the iPad mini when I'm on the go. It is super lightweight, surprisingly powerful for a quick note capture that you have when you're out and about. Now, I'll actually have a separate video on how I use both iPads, but today we're focusing on the model that you're using because the goal of today's video is to turn your iPad, really just any iPad, into a tool that you actually want to use for taking notes. Now, this video is part of my iPad 101 series, a guide to help you unlock the full potential of your iPad one tip at a time, and it all starts with the software. Apple Notes got a major upgrade in iPadOS 18, and some of the features, they're honestly game-changing. Now, this one is for the students out there, and it is reflowable handwriting. Now, this lets you move or rearrange your handwritten notes just like typed text with no erasing or rewriting required. It's perfect when you're reviewing class notes or when you forgot to add something and you need to make that space, you don't want to rewrite it all. Next, it's Smart Script. If you're writing fast in meetings on the fly, it automatically cleans up your handwriting without losing your personal style. Next up, it's Search, and this one absolutely blew me away. Apple Notes can now find words inside your handwritten notes more reliably just using plain text, and it just works. There's even a feature called Math Notes. You can jot down equations or do quick budgeting, and notes will solve, format them right inside of the note. But no matter how you slice it, the bottom line is that Apple is finally treating note-taking like a serious use case. And when you pair these upgrades with the right accessories, things really start to click. Now, speaking of things that click, click that subscribe button if you want to get more out of your iPad. I've got more video in the series, plus a full breakdown of iOS and iPadOS 19 when it comes out. You don't want to miss it. Next, let's talk tools, starting with the one that I use the most, which is the Apple Pencil. This is how I capture 90% of what goes into Apple Notes. Now, to make it feel like I'm actually writing on paper, I use a screen protector called Paperlike. The texture adds just enough resistance to make handwriting more controlled and more natural, especially during long writing sessions when you're like on a 90-minute call with someone, you gotta take notes. But here's the thing, none of that really works if your iPad is flat on the desk or awkwardly propped up. And that is where today's sponsor, Moft, comes in. This is the dynamic Folio, and it has completely changed how I take notes, sketch, and even use my iPad day to day. It is the thinnest folio I've used that actually lifts up the iPad to a usable height. Now, Moff's calling it the floating creativity station, and honestly, it lives up to that because I can sketch, write, or even annotate at the perfect angle without breaking my neck or my wrist feeling from cramping from looking down at my iPad. There's this mode, which is called the creation mode. It angles the iPad to 30 degrees, is where I spend most of my time when I am taking notes. And when I like to switch gears, maybe like watch a video, I use my iPad to control the music or my speakers, join a call. This is where the second screen or the second mode comes in. This is the theater mode, which is at a 60 degree angle. Now, if I'm planning out a shoot or journaling on the couch, writing mode gives me that perfect low angle. It's comfortable without needing a desk, and you can even pop your phone next to it for this really kind of cool dual screen mode if you need to multitask. And finally, there's browsing mode, which holds up the iPad upright at an 80 degree angle, making it ideal for reading vertically and staying hands-free when you do not want distractions. The design folds flat and has a built-in magnetic Apple Pencil sleeve. It feels ultra minimal, but also super intentional. Now, I think that Moff really nailed this design. If you wanna check out the dynamic folio, it is the first link in the video description. And Moff is giving everyone 10% if you use Michael10 on your order. Moff, thanks again for sponsoring today's video. Now, I still use the Magic Keyboard or a Bluetooth keyboard whenever I'm writing longer pieces, but the rest of the time, my iPad is propped up, Apple Pencil in hand, and I am ready to work. Now, when you combine the Apple Pencil with Paperlike and the Dynamic Folio, the iPad, it actually feels like you have a focused workspace, one that you wanna use every day. And once you dial in your physical setup, having a note-taking setup becomes a whole lot easier. Now, most of my notes start in Apple Notes. Whether I'm in a meeting, studying, or just doing some design work, Apple Notes is my place to begin. It's fast, it syncs instantly, and now with iPadOS 18, it actually handles handwriting so well that it can replace a physical notebook. You might disagree with me, and that's fine, but for me, it is finally there. Now, because it supports type text, scribbles, check marks, and even images, you can use it in the way that matches your brain in the moment, and for me, someone who's neurodivergent, this makes all the difference in the world. Now, one feature I started using a lot more is gonna be tags. Tags make it easy to group related notes together, like your research, without needing a separate folder. And now that you have smart search or smart folders inside of iPadOS, it just makes all the difference. Everything that you have in your Apple Notes is gonna stay protected behind your iCloud account. So if you have two-factor authentication, everything is super secure, and you can even lock the notes themselves with either Touch ID, a password, or Face ID. Now, when I need more structure, like outlining a project or reviewing slides, I like to go to Notability. It's great for separating things into subjects, adding audio recordings, and keeping my client notes organized. I don't use it every day, but when I do, it's because I need that extra level of control and organization. Now, for big picture thinking, which I absolutely love to do, whiteboarding, course planning, content breakdowns, I use Apple's Freeform app. The Infinite Canvas is perfect for me when I don't know what the structure is going to be, but I need something to get everything out of my head and start organizing visually. So whether you're a student, professional, or you're a stay-at-home parent, it's not about finding the best app, it's about building a system that fits the kind of thinking that you need to do. Since most of my notes start with Apple Notes, it only makes sense that my most used tool is going to be the Apple Pencil. So here are a few tips that have made a big difference in how I take notes. First, it's gonna be double tap gestures. I have mine set to quickly switch between the current tool and the eraser, and saving you way more time than you would expect, especially when you're writing fast or you need to fix something on the fly. If you have the Apple Pencil Pro, you can change it to squeeze gesture and you can actually use a shortcut. Second, don't sleep on Quick Notes. Quick Notes is absolutely probably one of the best features inside of iPad and macOS. You can swipe up from the bottom right corner to instantly jot down an idea, all without leaving whatever app that you're in. I use it for video ideas, meeting notes, or any time I don't want to interrupt my workflow. Now, if you're using SmartScript, here's something that most people don't know. If you don't like it, you can actually turn it off. Tap the markup palette, tap on the ellipsis, and toggle off Auto Refine Handwriting. And last, a hidden gem, long press on any handwritten text and you can copy it as text. Now these little tricks add up and they make Apple Notes feel faster, cleaner, and way more flexible. And these aren't just features, they're the building blocks of a smarter, more flexible note-taking system. And that one takes you from disorganized to organized, uninspired to inspired, and from scattered down to focused, all using Apple Notes. Now, if you missed the first video in iPad 101 series, it's all about changing the essential settings on your iPad so you can get everything running smoothly, whether you just got a brand new iPad or you've been using your iPad for a long time. I'll link this video at the end of this video. And if you just picked up a new tip today, drop down your favorite in the comments or let me know what you would change in your own setup. Now, big thanks again to Ma for sponsoring this video. And do not forget, you get 10% off the Dynamic Folio by using Michael10 at checkout. Now, I'm also continuing this conversation over on Threads, so if you want to share your setup, drop a note, or just come by and say hi, I'd appreciate it. Come on over. With iPadOS 19 just around the corner, make sure that you are subscribed because you do not want to miss that's coming next to Apple Notes in your iPad. My name is Mike, and guys, I'm out of here.